This is Street Starz and we're here with
Bush Bash, Bush King, Bush Waka, Bush Man, the Gallium Saucepan, you see?
Yo, this is Fonti, the Gallium Wanti, Fontilicious. It's all about FAB, FAB, Fonti and Bushkin, for those who don't know.
What's happening with that, man?
Boy, everything right now, man, we're just crushing them out there again, you know, because, boy, man, I'm going to soft out there, so I have to come back and just bring some substance to the scene, you know. Kind of left it for a hot minute, left it to a couple of them man out there, and the man is... Man, they let it dry up and, you understand?
Why did you leave it?
Boy, man, we said to leave it. You don't know, big family and them things there. Man, setting up home and, you know, just doing a little life. Doing the life thing. You're still keeping a little hand over there, but, you know, you give a man a thing to... Oh, man, them juggle that and manage that for a little while, man.
I would even say we went soft that day, you know, because you know what? I'll say we went soup out there, new one for them, yeah? Soup and have a business, you understand? When you're soup and have a business, you can't be two places at once, you get me?
Yeah, but I'm saying, I'm soup and have a business, I'm saying the rest of them went soft, man.
Alright, then, let's clear it up just in case we get the wrong way.
So, yeah, so good. But, yeah, man, I had to come back in, you know, how it goes, man. They shined a little Batman light and said, boy, assistance is needed. So they sent for the man then back again, and yeah, man, come back to shape up again, man. Fix back up the scene.
Alright, cool. Fonti.
Yeah.
We know that you done that S64 covering up what happened between the actual Heartless Crew. What exactly happened for those that still don't know?
See, now everyone always asks me, like, they say, like, Bush ain't got an opinion as well, you know.
Yeah, but I'm asking you. I'm asking both of you to hear it. But
like, looking for a little person. You know, it's exactly what it is, you know. It's exactly what it is. It's a sad story. I didn't even want to have to write that lyric there. You get me, basically. But every line that lyric there is a truth. You understand?
Oh, what caused you to actually write it up?
Like... Because, yeah. The bottom line of it is, yeah, it just looks as though, like, from when Bush did his one, yeah, when he put up his thing up on, like, that was like about 3 or 4 months after we was officially split up, yeah, and then he put out the blog on the beginning of January 2011, yeah, on New Year's Day, and he said the whole thing nice, you get it, basically, there was nothing really wrong with it. The only thing is, he didn't actually say the truth as to why we're not actually going ahead as a Heartless Crew anymore. He made it look sound as though all three of us had gone our separate ways, which wasn't the case. You understand? So I always felt a bit hurt in the fact of that, rah, okay, fair enough, we're not together, but that ain't the story, you get me? Bush just gave it a nice way, to be honest with you. To be honest, it more benefited Mold, he said it like that, because he didn't really want, like, it to look like, oh yeah, anything bad or more, you get it, basically, even though we know what he's done is bad, so we're trying to cover up his bad, to be honest with you. That's what Bush done. And I felt a bit upset about it, because I thought to myself, nah, man, the bottom line of it is, man's left and he stole the name. That's why, like, if he wants to leave, he can leave, innit? Me and Bush will still be Heartless Crew and take the same one, you get me, basically, because Heartless Crew was gone before Mo came in and should still be going if Mo wants to leave. It shouldn't be a thing where it's like, rah, man coming and smuggling thing and whatever, because that's exactly what happened. So I was holding that grudge for a long time, feeling myself like, rah, nah, man, this ain't right. And especially when fans are coming up to me like, oh, what happened with you, look, what happened with you, look? And I'm like, I feel like I can't even say nothing now, because Bush ain't really said anything, so what am I really going to say? Oh, yeah. Yeah, understand? And to be honest with you, yeah, I've come to a stage in my life now where I'm not really trying to douse my spirit. Whatever my spirit and emotion is telling me, that's what I'm dealing with, you get me? If I'm going to be true to myself, I need to be true to my spirit. So that means I've got to say what I feel and say what I really think. And people are talking to me and they're asking for my genuine opinion. For me to give them a genuine opinion, I'm going to have to say it to them. But I don't want to go around to one, two people and say, yeah, Mo do this, Mo do that, Mo do this. So I said, you know what, chat, I'm going to do F64. I'm going to say it one time and I have to say it again, because it's not a story I like to say. You understand still? So that's why I did an F64. And after that, I said, boom, that's it. Don't need to say nothing. I put all the details down in there. I don't need to give you that much details. But it's all there. You get it, basically. So yeah, man, it's like I said, it's a sad story, man, but boy, that's how that's the cat goes, you get it, basically, yeah, boy. To be honest with you, you know, I ain't gonna lie, I toned that lyric down, you know. When I first wrote that lyric there, boy, I had some different things in there, and I thought, nah, you know what, this ain't really a thing I'm looking to murder him lyrically or anything like that, you know, basically. I just want to tell the people, you get it, basically, but what was happening was, that it was anger was coming out, but I'm not gonna lie, I was angry when I was writing the lyric there, because... I'm seeing die-hearted fans like, oh, you man are rare, you man, oh, you man trying to sort it out. Everybody's kind of looking at it like to say, like, we kicked out Mo. Me and Bush are still rolling together and we kicked out Mo. That's the way I was actually looking. So it's making me feel even more like I'm holding the truth in, and now it's even looking even worse for me, like to say, like, oh, yeah, we kicked him out, basically, and decided not to use names. So it doesn't matter. I thought to myself, no, man, people have to know the truth, man. The people have to know the truth, you get me?
So there's no way it can be resolved now. That's it. You've just gone to separate us, pretty much.
Well, you know what, like, life is changing every day, you get basically, so you don't really know, like, what's really going to happen in the future, you get basically. I can only tell you, like, how I'm feeling and how things are going on, you get me? So, at the moment, like, time is the answer to that question, really and truly, you get me?
Alright, cool, man. Alright, so, what's the future with FAB, then? What you looking to do? I want to hear what you lot actually, if there's any tours planned, mixtapes, EPs.
Man looking to put an album, you understand? First, you know what we're doing again is just to warm up the scene, you know? Everyone forgets that you need a scene. When there's a scene, you understand, that's when things get bigger. Right now, there's not really a scene anymore, you know? When we was coming up, there was a scene there, you understand? Now it's like everything very fragmented, so there's not a scene. So first thing we're trying to do is just unite the vibe back and bring back a scene, you know? Mm. Yeah, the little tune in the background, putting out tunes out there, and it's making people enjoy it again. Cause you know what's happened out there? People forgot the enjoyment and the actual fun. Man, ain't really making up no fun lyrics and to make people really dance and have a good time. So man, looking to do that. That's the first base. You know, then first thing, put out some music videos, make people see how the party, the energy and all them things, and the vibes really stay. Yeah, because no one ain't really representing that at the moment. EPs, all them things, that's gonna come because it's a standard, that's just natural progression. But first thing first, man, I have to lay the foundation. That's why Heartless Crew was so strong, because we laid a very, very, very strong foundation. Coming like the three little pigs, you see something about it, a villa has some straw and all them things, everything blow down, one away. You know what I'm saying? I have to build a thing on the rock. So you see, that's what we're doing now with the FAB thing. It's only a year, but the name's stretching around already, people know what's really good. When they see us performing, they know the vibes, you can feel it. So we're just building up the thing on the rocks first, you hear me? Everything's gonna come, you're gonna get some tunes, yeah. You're gonna piss yourself. You're
gonna... Are you lot still coming with like the same type of sound, or are you lot switching it up?
Well, that's the thing, like, you see that our sound here, yeah? Our sound's always been switched up. If anybody will know us from back in the day, you'll know that we've always been diverse in our sounds. Mm-hmm. Originally, deep-rooted, us man is bashing the man at heart, really and truly, yeah, basically, still. So, we're always going to have that kind of reggae bashing influence in a lot of the stuff that we do, basically. Because those are like, if you talk about artists that we really rate, you understand, we're always going to mention the Jamaican artists, then we're probably going to be filling out the top 10. Yeah, it's like, but when it comes to performance, they might run another kind of level, another kind of hype. So because we got that kind of vibe with us, but at the same time, eclectic when it comes to sounds, mate. Like everything, you get basically. The songs that you probably even call cheesy, you get basically, like, we'll make that cheesy sound and put with some bun, and all of a sudden you eat that with some bun and cheese, you love that same cheese again. Yeah, I said, with crisp biscuit with them, basically, just make it tasty. So that's what music's about, really and truly, you know. Like, it's
mixing
about,
up everything, yeah.
Mixing up everything, and I love mixing up everything, because you know what one thing it does? It brings people together. Sometimes people just got aware that looking down on another person just because what they like is something different, you get me? So by the time I mix it together, but boy, they don't realize, they start to appreciate the next man for his thing, and next man can appreciate the next man for his thing, and you know what? It's love.
Alright, wicked, man. Alright, so if people want to get through to you lot and through the social media networks like Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, how can they get hold of you lot?
Yeah, you can follow me Twitter, at Fuller Fonti. The Facebook is jamming, I can't even keep up with that again still, you know, so I ain't gonna be like that. But yeah, again, the follow me on Twitter, at Fuller Fonti, at Fonti and Bushkin. Yeah. That's
account. Yeah, that's right. Boy, I'm there on Facebook and I'm all over Facebook still. I'm picking my people like carefully now, right, except, you know, because I've only got about 400 people left to accept. But my thing is Ricky Black, RIKIBLAC. Still, add me, you can request me still. Yeah, I ain't gonna gas it up, I'm just picking carefully now. But yeah, I'm all over that, and then my Twitter's Bush Bash. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And I'm all over Twitter, but my Twitter, my Facebook's linked up furthermore, so you don't know everything's legit.
Oh, thank you very much for the interview, man.
Also, let me tell you as well, you can check my SoundCloud, yeah? That's why I'm going to be putting up the new beats and production that we're going to be doing, yeah? At the moment now, we're getting to that stage now where it's getting comfortable in within the studio works, within the vibes, them thing there. So when we actually start to gear something, it's not just going to be like a 1-2, you're getting basically, it's going to be a series of music you're going to be getting basically, yeah? So check my SoundCloud, that is soundcloud.com/DJ-Fonti, F-O-N-T-I, yeah? Alright then, and yeah, keep updated.
Yeah, that's right, look out as well. Today we're launching our brand new, we've been doing a little reality show. Yes, and behind the scenes, because people always, oh, what are you man up to, man? It's tedious, people having to tell me, oh boy, we're doing this, you know what, we was in Brighton last week, boy, we're up Birmingham this week, boom, 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 where, you understand? So, we've been doing a little reality show, we've done a couple of series, and that's going to actually launch today. 8 p.m. It's gonna be on our FAB YouTube channel, Fonti and Bushkin on YouTube. So yeah, man, check that out as well if you wanna know what's really good with the man them and catch a little piece of the man's personality in them things there. Check that out as well. That's launching tonight, 8 p.m. Yeah, man, it's all gravy out there, man. Yeah. To the rest of the boys, man, don't feel no way, man. We're coming back to, you understand, to shut it down, man. So it's got easier out there, you understand?
So don't forget, Massive, yeah. Catch us at radio station, Rinse FM, 106.8 FM, yeah? Or Rinse.fm. 106.8 FM.
Is it?
Yeah.
I thought it was 106.8.
Oh,
okay.
I just listen
online, man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's 106.8, Rinse FM, yeah? Every Friday, 7 to 9 p.m., GMT. And also you can go online, rinse.fm, yeah? If you miss any shows as well, they've got all our podcasts or shows going all the way back years, yeah? So you just click in the dates, look for FAB, F-A-B, Fonti and Bushkin, and then you can just download however you do it. If it's a Mac, I think it's all control and download, something like that anyway. So you can work it out anyway still, but all the shows are there to download, Rinse FM, every Friday, 7 to 9.
Mad, maddest thing.
Back so they've got the iPhone app as well, yeah? You can listen on the go. Yeah, we got to the iPhone app, Massive Dave. If you got the Rinse app, big up.
The bush bash, the bush bash, bash, the bush bash, bash, the bush, good like bush, a lash. The bush bash, bash, bash.
Jeez!
Yo, remember I said also this week, bank holiday, no, bank holiday Sunday, this Sunday, the 3rd of June, the bank holiday, big bank holiday, Queen's Jubilee. It's all about my big birthday bashman down there, Club Zens, Bristol, up the M4, it's going to be a madness, whole of London's going up there, whole of Cardiff, Swindon, Reading's reaching, it's going to be a real madness, ourselves.
The whole M4, mate, if you're on the M4, it's all about the party, you know.
No. Us, Luck and Neat, Maximum Boy, better know, Old School Flirt of D, Sharky P, Martin Lana, Dennis GPA down there, Princess Naya, Discreet, Gemma Fox, CKP, I forgot more people, and there's others on the lineup, you know. Sure enough, the lineup is a mad thing, it's gonna be a crazy drink to get drunk affair. Remember, big up all my Geminis, ladies, come and dash out your pussy, you've done another thing, mad seller.
The bush bash,
murder.
The bush,
tell somebody.
The bush bash, bash.
The bush, the
bush,
Bristol.
The bush bash, bash. The bush, the bush.
Woo!